heart of the Lord. I want to thank the leadership of this church, all the workers and ministers that have helped me to raise the hand of this great man and great woman of God. It is my prayer that you will also get the pass of destiny in the name of Jesus Christ. You didn't hear me. I say you will get helpers of destiny in the name of Jesus Christ. It's a very prophetic prayer. A man without a helper will struggle in life. Jesus, our Savior, on the way to the cross to pay our price, needed a helper. Because at a stage, he was tired being human. Every time he took the cross, he fell. All of a sudden, God sent him help from nowhere. Amen?
Amen.
A man showed up from nowhere and helped him to carry the cross. May God send you help.
Amen.
You did not hear me. I said, may God send you help.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are in grace ministry. You don't deserve it, but grace is in it. Because you have sent, you have been sent help. I said, may God send you help.
Amen.
I don't know who I'm praying for. I don't know how long you've been waiting. I declare that the help of God is accessing you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prophesied.
Amen.
In the morning, we look at the topic titled, Guilty as Charged, but Acquitted by Grace. This afternoon, we want to look at responding to God's grace and mercy. They are connected. Perhaps for those of us who were not available in the morning service, you can get the tape from the media thing. Amen. Responding to God's grace and mercy. Mercy is very, very key for us. In Psalm 50, from verse 20 to 21, he said, you sit and speak against your brother. You slander your own mother's son. These things you have done, and I kept silent. You thought that I was altogether like you. But I will rebuke you and set them in order before your eyes. He said, we are children of the same mother. Say, Lord, send me mercy. How many times have we slandered ourselves? Every time when we leave church, we begin to speak things about ourselves. But God is saying, if you forget, he himself will never forget. But when mercy comes in, it will arise your wrong. There is no doubt, grace and mercy are God's ultimate expression of love to us. The question now is, how do I respond to this undeserved kindness and mercy of the Almighty God? Should we continue in sin because there is grace and mercy available to us? Scripture says, God forbid. And because we will not want to continue in sin because mercy abounds for us, there are things we need to do in order to respond to the mercy of the Almighty God. In order to respond to the love of the Almighty God. Remember the case of Solomon. Solomon was a product of a bad relationship. King David killed the husband of Bathsheba, murdered the man, impregnated his wife. And God stepped in, confronted David. David cried for mercy, but eventually God showed him mercy. But the child dies. In that same relationship came Solomon. One would have wondered, how can Solomon be a product of that relationship? Somebody say mercy.
Mercy.
Solomon came forth and God sent the prophet to name him, Prophet Nathan. He said, go and call him Jedidiah, which means the beloved of the Lord. Somebody said, mercy. And because God loved him so much, when Solomon grew up, what did he do? He responded back to the love of the Almighty God. He did not continue his sin because mercy spoke for him. Solomon was not the first child. He was not supposed to be the heir to the throne according to tradition. But God kept everybody, and the throne landed on the head of Solomon. And so when Solomon got to that throne, he responded. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, I will respond to the mercy of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Number one, how do I respond to the mercy of God? Recognize your inadequacy and always remember that everything you own is thanked to God. Amen? Always remember, if it is beauty, remember it is God that gave you beauty. If it is because you are handsome, remember it is God that brought you like that. If it is wisdom, remember wisdom comes from God. If it is money, know that it is He who gives the ability to make wealth. No matter how men try to press you down, no matter how people try to bring you down, if God is on your side, you will definitely stand out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. That is why He said that if God be for us, who can be against us? So it is not by strength, it is not by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. So remember your inadequacy, that you are just a human being. You are just a man without the breath of God. We are nothing. That is why when man is about to die, the struggle that the man goes through, because that breath of God is about to be taken from the man. You can imagine, it is the breath of God that is keeping us alive. He said, man became a living being because God breathed the breath of life upon man. Once that breath is removed, this body is sand. So know that whatever it is that you have is given to you by the Almighty God. That is the only way you can be humble, because God hates those that have pride in them. He said He resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. Pride goes before a man fall down. So if you don't want to go down, recognize your inadequacy and always remember that everything that you have accomplished, everything that you own, is given to you by God, because mercy spoke for you. Let's look at 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 9. 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 9 says that He will protect His faithful ones, but the wicked will disappear in darkness. No one will succeed by strength alone. John chapter 15 from verse 4 to 5. He said, remain in me as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do what? Nothing. Say to yourself, without God, I can do nothing. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, he said, I can do all things through Him who strengthened him. Talk to yourself that I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. I will finish this race because Christ is in me, because it will give me the strength and the grace and the ability to finish my course in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. To be able to respond to His grace and mercy fully, we must first recognize our need for such. Recognize that you need Him more than He needs you. We need Him more than He needs us. And because of this, we must humbly accept that we are all sinners and imperfect, and everything we have is because He gave us the grace to own them. Number two, accept Jesus' love and let this love change your life. Accept the love of Jesus. John chapter 3 verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He said, behold, I stand at the gate of your heart, and I knock. If any man open unto me, I will come in and I will sup with him. He is constantly there, knocking at the door of our heart. How long is it going to take you to open up to him? Accept his love. Accept his love. That is the only way you can respond to the grace that he is sending us this day. That is Revelation chapter 3 verse 20 I just quoted. Say, look, I stand at the door and knock. If you hear my voice and open the door, I will come in and I will share a meal together as friends. We will share a meal together as friends. He has given us his grace and mercy for free. Never asking anything in return. Thus, it is only right to accept this offer. The question I want to ask you, are you going to accept that offer today? Yes, guilty, but acquitted by mercy. But they say, yes, I want to acquit you. Are you going to accept my love? Are you going to respond to mercy this morning? Mercy is offered to you. For God so loved the world. It was his love for the world that made him to release his one and only Son. Most of us are parents here. Even if you have 10 children, how many of you are going to leave one? For God so loved the world, his one and only Son. He gave him heart because he wanted mercy to speak for you and me. How are you going to respond to that mercy? And when Jesus came, it was because of his love for us. Not that the Father only loved us. He himself loved us to the extent that he had to give his life. He had the choice. Because he came to his state, he said, Father, if this cup is not going to pass over me, let your will be done. So which means, his flesh can say, I will not go this way. But he decided because of the love that he had for us. And he gave his life. Are you willing to accept the love of God? And then having accepted the love of God, the third thing that you need to do in order to respond to grace and mercy is that accepting the love is not enough. Accepting the love of God is not enough. It is the first stage. That is what is going to bring salvation to you. And having accepted this love, the next thing you need to do that you need to grow to become like him. Grow to become like him. There is need for growth. Nobody can say, I am the same yesterday, today, and forever. If you have a child, as a woman, give birth to a child. 3 years later, the child is still breastfeeding. You would think that something is fundamentally wrong. Am I right? Yes. Because it says, as newborn babe, we should desire the sincere milk of the world. That who may do what? That who may grow. Another stage, he got to that stage. He said that when you come to a level, he said that, you know, bone is for what? For adults. It is for those who have grown to the extent that they cannot exercise their six senses to be able to discern the will and the purpose of the Almighty God. So there is no room for stagnancy. You need to grow. It is not enough to come to church. You need to grow. Let there be growth. You must be able to move from a stage of walking to begin to crawl. And when you begin to crawl, don't stay all year crawling. Move to the next stage and begin to walk. Because the path of the just is like a shining light that shines brighter and brighter unto a perfect day. And when you begin to walk, don't stop walking. Begin to run. And when you begin to run, don't end up in running. Grab up wings like eagle and begin to soar. That is where God is calling us to. Growing to become like him. Into the place of maturity. Growing to become like him, bring us to a place of maturity, to act by doing what? The needful. I'm coming to a close now. Amen. You want to correct that? Growing to become like Him brings us to a place of maturity. Where we act, let's know today, where we act by doing what? The needful. Where we act by doing the needful. This is what brings us to the topic. Soul winning. How do you grow to that place when you begin to do the needful? It is our month of soul winning. You have recognized your inadequacy. That it is by grace that you have been saved. You have moved on from there. You have accepted the love of Christ. And now you now begin to grow. Growing to become like Him. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18, it says, but we all with unveiled face, beholding us in the mirror, the glory of the Lord, have been transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. We have been transformed. We behold His image. Remember, in the same scripture, in John chapter 14, verse 9, he told one of his disciples, the disciple asked him, Jesus answered, don't you know me, Philip? Even after I have been among you such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? When you see me, you see the Father. I am the express image of the Father. So He's saying that you grow. If you are a man, grow to become like the Father. God is both male and female. Because He said that I am the strong and what? Breasted what? One. So when He's talking about man, He's not talking about man alone. Grow as a man to become what? Like me. He said we have been transformed, you know, to now begin to have the express image of Jesus Christ. Amen? So you are growing to become like Him. And it is this growth that brings you to a place of what? Maturity. And then, when we accept the grace, we begin to grow in His love. In time, this seed of love that has been planted in our heart will take roots and begin to what? Bear fruits. What are the kind of fruits it will bear when you get to this place? Number one, we become addicted to soul winning because we have grown to become what? Like our Father. While they were hungry, Jesus Christ said, go and look for food for us to eat. He tarried by the well and met the woman at the well of Samaria because what? He loved to win soul for His Father. It is this maturity. When they came, He said, I have eaten. They said, who gave Him food? He said, you don't know I have eaten because my food is to do the will of the Father. Every time a soul is pulled from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God, I have eaten something. It is maturity. Growing His love into the place of maturity that will take us to that world dimension. This is what brings us to the heart of soul winning for the kingdom of our Father. Because our love for soul winning has been what? Ignited. Maturity has taught us to become soul winners, knowing fully well that he who wins soul is wise and shall shine forever like the stars of the heaven. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 30. It says, the fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth soul is wise. It is wisdom to win souls. It is wisdom to become an addicted soul winner. You see, most men of God, they are flying from pillar to post winning souls. You wonder, what is their game? What are they looking for? The more people that comes in, the more souls that they want to win. What is that gain? It's here. It's in Proverbs chapter 11, verse 30. It said, the fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth soul is wise. I pray that God will give you wisdom.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In conclusion, in Daniel chapter 12, verse 1 to 3, it said, the great prince who stumbled washed over the sons of your people, and there shall be time there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was seen. There was a nation, even in that time. And at that time, your people shall be delivered, everyone who is found written in the book. And many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Some to everlasting life, some to shame and everlasting what? Contempt. Those who are wise, you have to read this with me. Those who are wise, they shall shine like the star, like the brightness of the firmament. And those who turn many to righteousness, they shall be like the star forever and ever. Wow. They shall shine. Their light shall not go down. Their light shall not go down. Have you heard about the prophet that even at death, his bone brought somebody back to life? His bones, dead body touched his bone and jacked back to life. He that winneth soul is wise. He shall shine like the star forever. You can't be an addicted soul winner and go down. No. That is what he's saying. We must all mature. Let not our attitude begin to drive people from the kingdom, but rather let us become the express image of God that begin to attract men into the kingdom of our Father. Let's rise up on our feet. I don't know about you. The time is ticking, but God is calling us. He's reminding us that the essence of our living is to ensure that God's kingdom come down and the will of our Father is done. Talk to the Almighty God. I don't know what your position is, but you can make this right today and begin to respond to His love for you. And accept His love and then begin to grow. And then let that growth trigger you to become an addicted soul winner for our Maker. Talk to the Almighty God. Tell Him that you are sorry. That you have not been able to win so the way you ought to win so. That this day you will turn a new leaf. Tell Him that His mercy will begin to speak for you. Tell Him to anoint you to become an addicted soul winner. Tell Him that you want to shine like the stars of heaven forever. Talk to the Almighty God. Talk to the Almighty God. You can't do it on your own. Tell Him to help you. Tell Him to help you. Tell Him that you need His help. Tell Him that you need His help. The apostles, when Jesus took them to a place of prayer, they couldn't pray until when He got to the book of Acts of Apostles, when they got the Holy Ghost. From that time, they became addicted to soul winning. In Acts of Apostles, if you read that, around chapter 5 and 5 or 6, Scripture recorded that when there were problems in the church, they came to Peter. This is Peter that was sleeping when Jesus went to a place, took them to a place of prayer. They said there was problem in the church. Peter said, look, look, look. We don't have time for this. We must dedicate ourselves to studying the word, to praying so that we can begin to win more souls. Look for somebody that will take care of the tables. Look for men with wisdom so that we can commit that responsibility into their hands. Talk to the Almighty God. Tell Him to take you to that level. Cry to the Almighty God. Father, we come before the throne of your grace. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
And Lord, I bring your people before the throne of your grace. We ask that this word will not be stolen from their hearts, O Lord.
Amen.
Let the word fall on the fertile ground. And let it grow so that they can grow into maturity and become addicted soul winners. No one serve you and go empty-handed. And Lord, as they go, we declare that they are blessed. Amen. Whatever it is that your mates and your peers are ahead of you, I speak into your life that receive divine speed,
Amen.
Divine acceleration,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible said that the hand of God came upon the prophet and he has run the chariot of Ahab. I speak into your life where you have experienced delay in this very year, you will experience divine acceleration,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You will outrun your contemporaries.
Amen.
You will outrun your peers.
Amen.
You will outrun your adversaries.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.